So, guten Tag. Heute werden wir ein paar mehr deutsche Idiome lernen. Ich glaube, das ist jetzt Teil 6 oder Part 6 of our series. Das steht auf einem anderen Blatt, which means that's a different story entirely, or that's a horse of a different color, we may say in English, meaning it's a different matter, okay? So, for example, that in literal German, it's just saying that stands or is written on another piece of paper. It's like that's something different from what we are talking about. Das ist nicht dein Bier. It's literally means that is not your beer, but it's also an expression that could also mean that is none of your business. So, literally, that is not your beer. Das Bier. Or another way possibly of saying this in German, probably less idiomatic, is das geht dir nicht an, which means it doesn't concern you. Ich drücke dir die Daumen. Just like saying, literally, I'm pressing my thumbs for you. And in English, America, we would cross our fingers for luck, but in German, you would drück die Daumen, which means you're pressing the thumbs. Das Projekt haben wir jetzt unter Dach und Fach. Which is just saying the project or whatever it is all wrapped up. It's completed, it's finished. So literal German, we have the project under roof and subject. The word das Fach is a subject, die Fächer is the plural, das Dach, the roof, and die Dächer, the roofs. Ehrlich währt am längsten. In English we say honesty is the best policy. Meaning it's better to be truthful. It's literally worth longer, last longer. Honesty does than the opposite, which would be lying. Währen is to last or to endure. Es geht jetzt alles im Eimer. Eimer is the word for a pail or a bucket in German. So saying something like everything is going down the drain is what we would say in English. Everything's getting worse. Es geht jetzt alles im Eimer. Everything is now going into the bucket. Eintracht nährt, Unfriede verzehrt. So this is saying united we stand, divided we fall. We will basically say we will succeed if we stay together and fail if we split apart. Literal German, you have harmony, Eintracht, nährt, nourishes, comes from the verb nähren, which is to nourish. Unfriede, which is discord or unpeace, if you want to think of it like that. Verzehrt, verzehren means to consume. Wir müssen das Eisen schmieden, solange es heiß ist. This is like saying in English, we say we must strike while the iron is hot, meaning we must act now while we can, and if we wait, it'll be too late. So, in literal German is we must forge the iron as long as it is hot. Schmieden is to forge, and a schmied is the word for a forger, yeah, not like false documents, but someone who creates things with iron. Es ist noch kein Meister vom Himmel gefallen, which means no man was born a master. Literal German, there's still no master who has fallen from heaven. It's just a way of saying that there's nobody is perfect and nobody knows everything about it, or whatever it is. So der Meister, the master, and der Himmel is heaven or sky. Okay, ich glaube, ein letztes. Es wird nicht so heiß gegessen, wie es gekocht wird. Which means it's, in English we'd say it's never as bad as it seems. Literal German is saying it will not be eaten as hot as how it was cooked. Essen, you have gegessen from the verb essen, which means eaten, kochen, you have the past participle gekocht, so it's cooked. Okay, ich glaube, das war's. Vielen Dank.